Hello everybody, my name is John Kenny and I'm a technology manager for Keysight. And I'm here today to talk to you about the new E36311, 12, and 13 triple output power supplies. These are our latest introduction into our general purpose bench power supply family. And they're really exciting products, probably more exciting than you've ever seen in a DC power supply. I'd like to show you several things that we've added to these to kind of enhance the experience relative to our older products, typically like the E36301. Right off the bat, you can see we have a large graphics display on this product, very similar, and in fact the same, as the existing DMMs, function generators, and counters. And this was done very deliberately because customer feedback was that we need to see full voltage and current on all the outputs of a multiple output power supply at the same time. Now we have it on our higher end bench product, the N6705, but never before did we have that capability in our base product, like the E36301. You had to select which of the three outputs you wanted to see at a time. And it was very clear that we needed to improve on that in order to get greater usability, which was a keynote set of features we wanted to add to this product. So we have the ability to see all three outputs at the same time. You can also highlight one of the three outputs, which you can select, to see more detail about it, more of the detailed settings for that output over the other two. Now, this graphics display gives us the ability to set up more capability than we ever could before in a product, and we took full advantage of that on the E36311, 12, and 13. And a great example of that is data logging. Data logging is a new enhancement that allows you to log voltage and current on the outputs over time. And this data logging capability is critical if you're trying to minimize power consumption of your device under test. But in addition, however, we've added a new capability previously only found in our more expensive products, which is low range current measurement. These products can measure down to less than 100 microamps of current, so you can characterize battery drain over long periods of time over a very wide range of currents. In the case of the 6-volt output, as high as 10 amps down to under 100 microamps. And that's never been available at this kind of price point before. The other capability you can see in this is the ability to set up output sequencing. Now, output sequencing is something that's become more common as parts and ICs, things like FPGAs and microprocessors, use multiple supply voltages. And they require that the outputs turn on in a very specific sequence, either up or down. We offered this feature in the N6705 for the first time, and customers were really excited. But this is the first time we've been able to bring that capability to a product at this price class. You can control the relative timing with millisecond resolution between the three outputs. And you can turn all the outputs on and off simultaneously with a single press of a button with that timing control between the three outputs. You then can turn them off. You also, if you'd like, have individual control of the outputs just by pressing a button for that output, all color-coded. Okay, so you can see that our display now has a very rich set of capability. We also have the ability to have list sequences, which are the ability to have voltage and current and time pairs to create step sequences through different tests. And this is useful for complex burn-in setups and several other requirements. So the display really gives us that ability to show all these kind of capabilities in this type of product. When before we just couldn't do it. You'd have to have a computer program or you'd have to have a function independent of this, and strong customer feedback was they wanted it built into the product. So a couple other capabilities I wanted to illustrate for you here was the ability to control both voltage and current with separate knobs. We got strong feedback that people didn't want to have to use menus to switch the functionality of a single knob. So we have independent voltage and current control, which allows you to go and turn the voltage and current settings up, as you can see, independently. We also have numeric keypads, so if you want to enter the value for your setting directly because you know it needs to be 4.2, you can pop in 4.2 very quickly. And that was also strong feedback that many times people have very specific settings. They want to go to 5.25 or 3.0 and they don't want to have to turn the knob to get it close in there. Next thing I wanted to talk about was our binding posts. We have full output binding posts for all the outputs, and it's something we've added relative to the 3631. Was the 3631 had output 2 and 3 locked together, wired together directly. On the 36312 and 13, these are completely independent and floating, And this gives you more flexibility for your test setup. So if you want the two to be common ground or you want them to be plus and minus, you can do either one. Furthermore, if you want to tie them together, you don't have to run wires between the outputs. You can electronically switch them into auto series mode and they'll wire with the internal relays together. And they'll also measure the complete voltage between the two outputs as a single voltage. So you can get higher voltages that way, up to 50 volts. In addition, you can also go into what we call auto parallel, and it'll actually create a single output that's twice the current of either the two 25 volt outputs for those higher current applications. And again, that's all done electronically. It reports one voltage, which is the common voltage, one current, which is common current, and it reconciles all the messy status so that if one output's in a different mode than the other, it tells you the single mode for the net power supply you get. So the binding posts are great, but as you can notice, there's only enough binding posts for us to bring the output voltage and current out the output. There's no sense on the front panel. And frankly, with the kind of currents that you can deliver on these products as high as 10 amps, if you want the kind of accuracy that we talk about for our specs, and we have some of the best accuracy in this product class, you really need to use remote sense in some cases. So another enhancement we added relative to the E36301, we added rear connections. And on those rear connections, we have full remote sense. And that remote sense is fully switchable electronically from local to remote sense. And you have that for output 1, output 2, and 3. Full access to that on the rear. And the rear panel connections in themselves are important because a lot of customers want to use this on the bench or they want to use it in the system. Once they get their test program worked out on the bench, they want to mount one of these right in their system. So you can then run all your wires on the back without having to dress them from the binding posts. You can use these two-piece connectors, which are much easier to wire up, and then you can plug them in after you're done. It also makes, if you have to remove this for any reason to service or support, it's very quick without changing any of the wiring. A couple other high notes on the rear. We have a digital I/O. This is a very useful feature which allows you to trigger the output changes. It also allows you the output to generate triggers if any faults occur. You can shut the outputs down due to any emergencies in the system, a panic switch, or if someone opens a fixture, you can wire that in. You can also use that if you need more than three outputs and you want to control sequencing for six outputs, for example. Two boxes, you can slave them together. One button press, they all turn on or all turn off. So it's a very capable set of digital I/O, and it's fully compatible with all our other products that have the same type of connector. So the N6705 can be connected, or our Olympus products, which are the N6700 1 and 2, can all be connected together with this product. So if you need higher currents, which are available in those products, they can all be linked. A couple other things to point to, we have LAN, USB, and optional GPIB. Now the 11 only comes with USB. The 12 and 13 come with LAN and USB, and both offer optional GPIB, which is user field installable. You can order it from the factory with it, or you can install it yourself after the fact if you find out you need it. So altogether, a very flexible set of capabilities, as you can see from the rear. And the last thing is this big fan you see in the back. The fan is actually a revolution for us. This is the quietest bench power supply we've ever made, and we believe it's the quietest in its class. And we deliberately designed this to be extremely efficient, so this fan spins very slowly and very quietly. In fact, before it was on, and you couldn't hear it at all. As you can see, that's the quietest you can get. So overall, a lot of things have changed. This is not an E3631 anymore. This is really the new standard for bench power supplies. So this is John Kenny reporting to you from Keysight. Thanks for watching.